when DSM-3 came out and the major depression diagnosis was created, it was almost immediately clear that many people who were recently bereaved were going to qualify for that diagnosis. So the question became, what should we do about that? And the answer ultimately was to create an exclusion, to say that if you're within 2 months of a bereavement, you can't, and you meet the criteria for major depressive disorder, you don't qualify for the diagnosis. You can't be diagnosed. Now, this is obviously incoherent. It doesn't make any sense at all. Does it matter if you have lung cancer? Does it matter if you smoked? Mm-hmm. Obviously not. Mm-hmm. So either if these things are really disorders, then it shouldn't matter whether you're in mourning or... And so some research was done showing that there's no difference between bereavement and unemployment or foreclosure or divorce or any of the other catastrophes that people frequently, unfortunately, meet in their lives. So there was no reason to limit the exclusion to grief if you were going to have an exclusion at all. So mm-hmm. the question quickly becomes, do we reinstate a diagnostic system based on what symptoms actually mean, where they come from, how they fit into a person's life, or do we stick to our guns and insist that these disorders are medical problems whose origin and nature don't really matter?